We have 5 squares and 5 shaded triangles that meet at a common point. Our goal is to find what fraction of the total area is shaded without knowing any numerical values related to the triangles or the squares. Now I know this seems impossible, but there's an elegant way to find the answer. Here's how we can do it. In geometry, there's a cool property of triangles that states that if a vertex of a triangle moves along a line parallel to its base, the area doesn't change. If that brief explanation didn't connect, here's a visual. We know that a triangle's area is calculated by using its base and height. The base can be any line of the triangle, so that's pretty easy to picture. The height, though, is slightly harder to wrap our heads around without seeing a visual of it. A triangle's height is the line perpendicular to a given base that reaches to the opposite point of that base. And with this definition of a triangle's height, we can do some pretty creative things. For instance, we can say that a triangle's height can exist outside of the triangle. I know that sounds a bit weird, but don't worry because we can make an illustration. Let's draw 2 parallel lines. One intersects the point opposite to the base, the other occupies the same space as the base but extends out beyond the triangle. By definition, if we draw another perpendicular line that spans the distance between these two horizontal lines, we get the triangle's height. And here's the cool part. As long as the length of this vertical line remains the same, we can shift it along the two horizontal lines as far as we want, and the area of the triangle would not change. This is what I meant when I said the height of a triangle can exist outside the triangle itself, and it's a crucial discovery for solving our problem at the start of the video. But this is just the beginning, because now that we know shifting this line doesn't change the area of our triangle, we can also say with certainty that shifting this point opposite to the base along the horizontal line doesn't change the area of our triangle. What this means is that, as long as these three lines don't change, our triangle can take many different forms and have the same area. And this can be directly applied to our problem. Here's how. All of our triangles have a vertex that meets at this common point. Let's say that for all the triangles, this is the opposite point to their bases. What this allows us to do is slide each triangle's point along the line parallel to its base. For these two triangles, let's say that these lines are their bases, and for the other three triangles, these lines will be their bases. So with that in mind, let's try and see if we can make these triangles easier to work with by turning them into right triangles. To do that, all we need to do is slide each of their points like so. This makes our problem much easier to solve because now we can divide our diagram into smaller rectangles where the triangles we just made reach across one of their diagonals. And if you know a bit of geometry, you would recognize that these triangles shade half of the area of their respective rectangles. Which means, when we combine them all to form our original diagram, the shaded regions take up one half of the total area. And if you want to solve a similar problem, check out this video next.